Superstitions can be considered one of the major problems that India is currently facing. It is regarded due to the lack of education in India. However, this is not exactly the reason. The literacy rate in India is approximately 74%. But still, even the educated ones believe in superstitions. Am I the only one who feels like this should be stopped? Well, here's how at least we can stop being superstitious. It all starts from the beginning, doesn't it? Well, this means that you should know the origins of the superstitions you tend to follow. For instance, we'll talk about the origin of the unlucky number 13. Well, why is 13 the only number which is regarded the most unluckiest among all those infinite numbers? Well, it goes back to the time of Jesus Christ, when he was having dinner with his 12 disciples. And if counted them, they would be 13. Just after that, he got arrested and crucified. Yeah, that's a really sad legend. The second one, the black cat theory. Wait, don't go there. There's a black cat over there. That's unlucky. Whoa, why is that? Actually, Egyptians used to worship cats during the 17th century. Even King Charles had a pet cat, that too, a black cat. He thought she was responsible for most of his wealth and, you know, like, resources and his achievements. But during the Middle Age, people started associating black cats with the color black, and that to witches and to evil spirits and all that spooky stuff. Even cats face racism. Hey, that's bad. How they affect our life? Possibly, they don't affect our lives in any magical or scientific way, but in a psychological way. We just become picky about things like, but sometimes it do has a really good purpose. For example, imagine a situation. You are having an exam next day, and the day before you do study good, but you lack in confidence a bit. But then you have there your magical, lucky pencil to save you. And you write your exam with the pencil. And then you see a A+ grade on your paper. You feel it's the lucky pencil who saved you. Then you got confidence from it. But sometimes, imagine a similar situation in a different way. Like it's again the day before exams and you really don't want to study and you are like, you have that same wooden pencil that will save you. And you see on your result paper a big F. Whoa, why is it that? Why did I got F? I had my lucky pencil, right? But this time, it was the overconfidence you got from the pencil. This means superstitions have both good and bad purpose as well. It generally stops the mind thinking logically and practically, but sometimes it boosts your confidence. It's all about luck. We do follow it for our luck, don't we? We should realize that nothing but we can make our own luck. It depends on us. How we work, how we talk, how we react, how we interact with people. It's all because of our luck. This leads us to the last and the most important step, being optimistic. People believe in superstitions because they just expect something bad in every phase of their life. They just get convinced that there's something going to be bad in our day and we need our luck for that. And there are superstitions for that. We should be optimistic, a true optimistic, not a blind one. What is this? True optimistic, blind optimistic? Well, blind optimists are those people who feel like there's nothing bad in their life, there's everything perfect, and superstitions are there for their good and stuff. But we should be a true optimistic. This means that we should be ready to face the problems we have in our life in a positive way. Now, ask yourself, are superstitions really that important to you, you know?